May I come in, sir? Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Thank you, sir.
How are you, Radhika? How are you?
I'm good, sir. Thank you.
Where is this Alirajpur located in Madhya Pradesh? Which
Sir, it's the northwestern part of, southwestern part of Madhya Pradesh. On the yes, sir, border district of Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh.
Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh.
Yes, sir.
So it is Gujarat, it is northern or southern?
Sir, southern western, southwestern. Yes, sir.
Tell me something about this National Minimum Vehicle Cost Competition. What is this?
Sir, during our college, we were part of a team, a Baha team. We used to participate in a national level collegiate competition. And in that competition, we had to build an all-terrain vehicle, off-road vehicle. So this was a one-year-long project. And that, sir, I was the team lead for minimum vehicle cost. So one of the competitions in that event was to reduce the cost to the minimum possible parameters, keeping in mind the safety of the vehicle. So this was the project, sir, where I used to, where we led a team and we reduced the cost of vehicle from somewhere around 6 lakh to 3 lakhs.
What was that vehicle?
This was a vehicle that a team of 25 members from the college used to build. And that vehicle used to take part in a competition that used to happen in Pithampur. So that was a 4-day event, sir, national level event.
No, I'm asking what type of vehicle was produced? Yes. Cost was reduced to half.
So this was all-terrain vehicle, off-road vehicle. So we used to produce that, we used to make it in-house. The entire assembly, manufacturing, design, all of that used to be done online, in-house, sir.
So what was the factors for reducing the cost? Okay. Whether you took out some parts, like cycle, like mudguards are removed, cycle will run, but cost
yes,
saving
sir.
Is there.
Yes, sir. We took several measures to reduce the cost of the vehicle, ranging from manufacturing everything in-house and not importing products. For example,
That is one thing.
Mm-hmm. Sir, apart from that, the second is, sir, with respect to safety parameters also, we did designing on the CAD softwares, ANSYS and PROE. So that reduced our cost to a great extent because we could optimize according to the safety standards that were needed in the event itself. So we did not compromise anywhere on the safety because safety check is the first thing that is done.
No frills.
Sorry, sir.
No frills. Means if some it is basic things are put there and showy things are taken out, that will reduce the cost.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We did that in terms of painting also, sir.
Okay. And I see you're working somewhere now?
Yes, sir. I'm currently a probationary officer in Indian Railways, personal services.
Okay. It's not.
Sir, I got in through reserve list and that's why it is not mentioned in my DAF.
Did you join?
That's
yes, sir.
You have opted only for a few services, no?
Yes. Okay.
So just tell me, by the next decade, what 3 or 4 sectors will show very prominent growth?
So the first sector that comes to my mind is the automotive sector. In the next 5 years, I believe that it will show a very promising growth. In terms of the shifting, because it's in a phase of transition right now. So electric vehicles and automotive sector is one factor. The second sector is the tourism sector. It is, in India, it is still in its growing and nascent phase. So that is another sector that has a lot of potential. The third is, sir, in terms of manufacturing, there are various sectors ranging from the renewable energy sector, which has a huge potential in India and given the NDC targets also. And next is agriculture. Again, I believe that it has a lot of potential given we have a large population in agriculture and still it contributes to a lesser amount to the GDP.
So IT is saturated?
No, sir. IT is also booming right now and India is doing good in services sector also, sir, in IT sector.
Reparation law. Have you heard of that? It was in newspapers, whether we need a law, reparation law.
I'm sorry, sir. I do not know
that,
about it.
Wrongful confinement, wrongful prosecution, that people should be compensated for that.
Sir, as such, I do not know about the law.
But okay, what is your opinion? That sometimes arrests are made just for the sake of making arrests and wrong prosecution is also there. And people are allowed to put in jails for many years without any charge sheet. And all of a sudden found that there are no charges against him, released.
Sir, in our I do believe that in our criminal justice system there are various flaws in terms of the number of under trials and the years for which the under trials remain in jail. But at the same time, sir, I believe that it is more of a criminal justice system reform that we need rather than a new law itself, because the new law again would increase to more litigation in terms of the reparations or the damages that have been caused to the individual. No doubt there are damages to the social prestige of a person.
Person's life financial. Is spoiled, family is spoiled, life is gone.
Yes sir, definitely there is a lot of loss to the person, not just financial but social also. But at the same time, sir, I believe that the more pressing need of the time is to reform the criminal justice system in a way that justice delivered is in due time, so that these things do not occur and they are minimized.
Okay. In our country, we find a lot of labor is available, cheap labor is available, and we are able to put any type of servants or maids in the houses. But Western, the system is not there. Everything you have to do yourself. You have to, even women also, they have to do full-time job and then all work. Of course, men also contribute. So what do you think, that women in India also should adopt this system? Or they should be only working, if they are full-time working outside, household work should not be their duty?
Sir, I believe that household work is as important as any other job and it should be given that due respect. So, sir, in that sense, I believe that both the partners in a relationship or in a family are equally responsible for that household work. And given the fact that if both of them work outside, household work becomes the duty of both of them. And even in otherwise scenarios, sir, I believe that household work is actually a very much of a work, it is as similar to as we going out and contributing to the economy. So it does contribute to the economy. So it is as important as any other work, sir. And sir, comparing it to the Western system, I also believe that in India, because we have the culture of the house help, it gives employment to a lot of people. However, sir, we need regulation in that aspect because the minimum wages labor laws are flouted there. So that kind of regulation needs to be brought in so that minimum wages are paid to the employees and okay. They have certain contract.
Article 280 and Article 243, why? Anything common in this? What is 280?
I'm sorry, sir. I'm not able to recall.
Finance Commission?
Recommendations. Yes.
What recommendation? 280 is Finance
Commission. Commission. Yes, sir.
And 243? What is 243? Any?
So, to the best of my knowledge that I can recall, 243 is related to the parliament, the seats in parliament. But I am not sure.
That is 243 is local bodies.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Rural as well as urban local bodies.
Thank you, sir.
Recently, you would have read this 9/11 was there.
Yes, sir.
And some revelations have come from US side. They have released some 20-year-old papers. Mm-hmm. Something about Saudi.
Sir, there was a news about a person whose name I'm exactly not able to recall. So a video surfaced where he claimed that he's still alive, and there were news reports from the US very early that he has already died. So that revelation was there.
No, that was, you're talking about Al-Qaeda.
Yes,
I'm talking about the papers. They are telling that there are allegations that Saudi Arabia government was involved in 9/11. Okay.
I'm sorry, sir. I do not know. Thank you, sir.
You joined already in the Indian Railway Bus. Very good. Now tell me, you passed out from Don Bosco and then went over to Kota.
Yes.
You need to prepare for engineering service entrance.
Yes, sir. I went to Kota for IITJ entrance examination.
Then you got into the, what is it? SGSITS? What is the full form?
So the full form of this is Sri Govindaram Sekh Saria Institute of Science and Technology.
Who was Govindaram?
He was a very prominent businessman from Indore. So when the college was to be opened in Indore, his son Kudilalji Sekh Saria, so Nehruji at that time wanted an engineering institute in Indore and in the heartland of India. So it was Kudilalji Sekh Saria who built the college in the name of his late father, Mr. Govind Ram Shekhsaria. So he was a prominent businessman there.
Tell me, under this mechanically, what subject did you study in particular?
So there are various subjects that we study as part of mechanical engineering, ranging from thermodynamics to
okay, the... let's talk about thermodynamics. What are the three laws? Do you recall any or all the three?
Yes, sir. The zeroth law of thermodynamics.
Start from one. Yeah. What is the first law?
So there are three laws, zeroth, first and second. So the zeroth law of thermodynamics says that when two systems are in thermodynamic equilibrium with each other, and the system is in equilibrium with another system as well, so all of the three systems come in equilibrium with each other. This first law of thermodynamics says that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only be transformed from one form of energy to another form of energy. Second law of thermodynamics, sir, it says that it talks about entropy of the system, the randomness of the system, which always increases.
Good. You remember.
Thank you.
Okay. Oh, you passed it only in 2017. How much did you get in the first interview?
So 182 marks.
182. And who was in the chairman?
Ma'am Sujata Mehta, ma'am.
Oh, she's still there. I hope again you met her there.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. About Madhya Pradesh. There was one Jal Satyagraha. What was that? Can you recall anything of that? Which is the most important river in Madhya Pradesh?
Sir, Narmada River.
Narmada. Yes, so, some satyagraha related to that?
Yes, sir. It was, to the best that I can recall, it was related to the building of Sardar Sarovar Dam and the protests that were going on around the Sardar Sarovar Dam. So, the satyagraha basically...
Who led the satyagraha?
Miss Medha Patkar.
Medha Patkar. Now tell me what exactly is it? It was something very unique.
Sir, the best that
born fast.
Yes, sir.
Sir,
they were standing inside the river and that was something special about that. But that's...
How many days? You stand for half an hour and nothing happened, no?
Sir, I'm sorry, I don't know the exact number of
more days. Than 10 days. Okay, that's all right. What is this? Reflective journalism, something you have used. What exactly is that?
Sir, reflective journaling is one of the hobbies that I have been pursuing.
Your hobby? Okay. Yes, sir.
Sir, it's a way of journaling the daily aspects and incidences of my life. And I also not just journal about those happenings in my life, but I also try to reflect upon the incidences that I come across or the experiences that I have. In the sense that it's a kind of a dispassionate analysis that I do with whatever I come across in my life. So that's it. That is reflective journalism.
In what way it is useful? If you have done something wrong, if you feel you try to correct that in future?
Yes, it is. It's very helpful for me in the sense that it has made me grow as a person. It has made me a lot more calmer and a rational individual. So whenever, as an individual, I do make mistakes, and when I reflect upon those mistakes with a cooler head, I try to understand that this is where I have done wrong. So the next time something similar happens, it's a check that I always get, and I'm reminded of that with the hobby.
Do you think this will help you when you become a civil servant? I mean, you are already, but anyway, then you become a collector in Nagaland, for example. Then this sort of thing will help you?
Yes, sir. I do believe that reflective journaling will help me a lot, because this as a hobby has not just made me consistent in my efforts, but it has improved me in a lot many ways. So, all the qualities that are needed for a civil servant, they grow with time. So, with time, this journaling has also helped me grow those qualities of honesty, of integrity, of accepting my mistakes and working on those mistakes. So, I think, sir, in that sense, it will help me in my career as a civil servant.
Very good. Now, tell me about gender budgeting. What is gender budgeting?
So gender budgeting is an aspect of budgeting where different aspects with respect to gender, the allocations are done. For example, sir, special allocations to be made with respect to women or a particular gender, not just women, but even the third gender. So when that kind of budgeting is done, keeping in mind the needs of the particular gender, that is called as gender budgeting.
Very good. Have you heard of Nirbhaya Fund? What is the Nirbhaya Fund?
Sir, Nirbhaya Fund was a fund which was created for the women, specifically after the Nirbhaya case that happened in 2012 in Delhi. So it's a non-lapsable fund.
That is unique. Recently also we had a Nirbhaya thing. in recent days. Can you recall any incident like that?
Sir, a Dalit child was murdered and raped.
Bombay. Yesterday or day before. You didn't hear or read in the paper?
I'm sorry,
sir. Similar thing. The poor lady died.
I'm sorry, sir, I'll read about
it. I thought Nirbhaya, and they are called it Nirbhaya also. Yes. Very unfortunate. Yes. Okay, on the budget, you recall anything? 2-3 major points on the budget?
So the major, the budget...
With reference to income tax, let me put it that way.
So with respect to income tax, the time limit, there were a loan moratorium that was given. To the sectors of MSME in terms of, with respect to corporate taxes, the taxes have been slashed.
Personal income tax.
Okay. Sir, in personal income tax, the time limit, the threshold was increased to 5 lakhs from the earlier limit in terms of the taxes. That is all I can recall as of now, sir.
Anything about the assessment?
Yes, sir. Faceless assessment. Yes, sir.
It will help in the ease of living?
Yes, sir. I do believe that faceless assessment will help in the ease of living in the sense that a lot of harassment and the discretion of the person gets reduced when there is faceless assessment. So, that way, sir, it is very good for the...
So, there is a ranking of ease of living. What is our rank? Present rank? India's rank? Is it improving or going down?
I'm sorry, sir, I don't know the rank.
What is the ease of doing business? There is another concept called ease of doing business.
Sir, ease of doing business is another ranking which is given by World Bank. And India has been doing good for the last couple of years in ease of doing business in terms of improving its rank to 63 as of now from 150 in the last 5 years. So that...
Again, in the budget, you were mentioning about corporate tax. Now tell me, what is there in the budget with respect to corporate tax?
Sir, it was slashed to a lesser amount, but the exact number again I'm not able to recall. It was reduced. Corporate tax was reduced.
Okay. Have you seen any report of Niti Aayog? Do you know anything about Niti Aayog?
Yes, sir. It's the premier research think tank of the Indian.
Think tank.
Yes, sir.
Is it a new avatar of Planning Commission?
Yes, sir. It's a reformed and a rejuvenated avatar of Planning Commission because it focuses on the...
You have not seen any report.
Yes, sir. I have seen. There are various reports that are given. CWMI is one report that I can recall. So, Composite Water Management Index was one report that was given.
Something about it.
Sir, the report talked about the ways the states were managing their water resources. So it was ranking the states based on that, and some of the states did really well, ranging from Himachal Pradesh to Karnataka and Tamil Nadu.
Where does Madhya Pradesh figure in that?
Sir, it came to somewhere around 10 or 11, but exact rank is...
Is there any problem in Madhya Pradesh with regard to availability of water or anything? Are you self-sufficient, even if you become Narmada goes to Gujarat?
Sir, currently Madhya Pradesh is not water stressed, but at the same time, sir, given the agriculture performance that Madhya Pradesh is giving, but at the same time, sir, despite having good agriculture growth, there is issue with respect to groundwater exploitation that is there in Madhya Pradesh. So it is increasing for the last couple of years.
Thank you,
sir.
Radhika, recently there was a judgment to provide compensation for a railway passenger,
who was missing his train. Have you read about this? It's in the last 1 week.
So this was related to Tejas Express?
No, some other passenger who had lost his connection flight or something, and he was compensated 20,000 rupees.
30,000
rupees.
No, sir, I do not know.
Do you think it would be a good idea that, you know, railway should be held accountable for its delays?
Yes, sir. I do believe that punctuality is something that we need to provide to our customers because it's the customers that we are serving. And in that regard,
but
sir...
But it's such a big organization with a lot of people involved. Do you think it will be practical to ensure punctuality?
Sir, Japan as a country is also a huge country and it runs its system and
it's not a huge country. It's smaller than many of our states.
Yes, sir. But despite that, sir, it is extremely punctual, the systems in Japan. So I think, sir, given the large... manpower base that we have in railways, we can definitely work and improve and provide the military level punctuality to our
customers. The railway is already under loss. It has a lot of financial burden.
Yes, sir.
So imposing something like this, will it be practical?
Sir, it may not be practical in the current scenario, but I think, sir, this will set a deterrent and this will push our employees also to...
So we can make it compulsory for the private players who come in.
Sir, as of now, this has not been made compulsory. But sir, to take the example of Tejas Express, it does provide compensation if the train gets delayed by 1 hour or 2 hours. So, sir, in that sense, it actually provides better public service delivery to the customers. So it also keeps the train running staff on its toes to maintain punctuality.
About Indian judiciary, it is said that the process is the punishment. Why do they say that?
Sir, it is often said that the process is a punishment with respect to Indian judiciary because the judicial system in India has a lot of problems in terms of the delays that we face. So a person right from accessing the judicial services to getting justice in the end, there are a lot of delays that a normal citizen faces. So that is why in that context, it is said that the process is in itself a pain. So, sir, but I do believe, sir, that there is a lot of room for improvement there in terms of our judicial functioning.
Okay. Ford is exiting the country. What will be its impact on existing stock of vehicles and on resale vehicles of Ford?
Sir, Ford is exiting and there is a lot of impact that is there on the dealerships that are there of Ford. So currently, there is a huge stock that the dealership has in India. And all these dealerships are skeptical in the sense that if the Ford exits, what happens to the current existing stock of the Ford vehicles? Because there is a sentiment among the people to not buy the vehicle, given the after sales services. So that is one impact that is there. And sir, another is that as customers, they lose the choices also. That is second impact. And third is,
what will be the impact on second-hand vehicles of Ford?
Yes, sir. The resale value will definitely go down because people will not be willing to buy the Ford vehicles. And the after sales also of the existing vehicles which are already sold, that is also skepticism that it might get compromised.
What are some other vehicle manufacturers who have entered India and exited?
Sir, Harley Davidson has also exited India.
Not now, in the last 10-20 years. There are other players also who have exited.
Yes, sir. So General Motors has also exited before Ford. These are the two I can recall for the international players.
Why are they leaving? Why is Ford leaving?
So the major issue with the international brands like Ford and Harley Davidson or with respect to General Motors is that India as a country has relies very much on the low budget vehicles, pocket friendly vehicles, which are smaller and which are economical to the common middle class man in India. So, sir, in that sense, in these particular categories, these companies of Ford and General Motors could not beat Suzuki and Hyundai. So, they are currently providing a very good amount of choices to the customers in those smaller segments. So, sir, that is one reason that they have not been very profitable businesses in India. One reason of leaving that. And second is, sir, that even in larger segments, their manufacturing costs are higher as compared to the other Indian companies. So, sir, because of the Indian market and the peculiar demands of the Indian market, these companies have suffered losses and they exited Indian markets.
I see a approach where manufacturers like Toyota, they outsource manufacturing to Maruti and they just brand themselves as Toyota. Like take the case of Baleno and Glanza. Why do such big manufacturers like Toyota do that?
So one of the reasons of big manufacturers doing that is because of the already established manufacturing chains and supply chains of established brands like Suzuki in India. So in that sense, sir, there's a lot of cost saving that goes in it. And at the same time, sir, that cost saving actually makes their profit business profitable. The second thing is, sir, that the companies like Suzuki, they understand the demands of Indian markets better as compared to other brands, the international brands. Sir, in that sense also, it does help.
So, is it a validation that Indian market does not require quality cars? It just requires Maruti cars?
No, sir. I would humbly beg to differ that there. I do believe that Indian markets, it's a very diverse market. So, ranging from the smallest Alto 800 car to the limousine cars, everything we can find in India. So, sir, in that sense, because we are still a developing country and we are still largely a a country where the large population of the nation requires budget-friendly cars. So, sir, in that sense, the demands are diverse. So, we do need both the time, both the types of cars to fulfill the aspirations of people.
Vehicle scrappage policy. Can you tell me something about it?
Sir, with respect to the vehicle scrappage policy, I think it's a step in the right direction in the sense that there are several petrol and diesel cars over the 15 years or 20 years of their window which are plying on the roads. So, first of all, sir, they are not safe in terms of the safety aspects. The second is, sir, that they're not just safety, they also pollute the environment because of the deterioration of the parts that happen. So, sir, in both the senses, the vehicle scrappage policy came to reduce the number of vehicles, especially in our metro cities like Delhi and Mumbai, where a lot of vehicles ply more than the demand. And sir, third, the vehicle scrappage policy will also incentivize purchases in the auto sector, and it will help indirectly in the revival of the sector itself.
Okay. What are other policies by the government with respect to dealing with vehicular pollution?
So we have norms with respect to the CATCON emissions that need to be there. The exact law I'm not able to recall, but with respect to the air pollution laws, there are parameters as to how much of NO2 and SO2 pollution can be there from the CATCON. So sir, that is there in India.
Okay, Bharat norms.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. BS6 norms, BS4 and BS6. So currently there is a shift from Bharat stage 4 norms to Bharat stage 6 norms also.
Vehicles should not run after 10 years and 15 years.
Yes, sir. Yes. Okay. Thank you, sir.
You have something called as listening TED Talks and podcast on life lessons. Can you tell me some life lessons that you have learned from doing this?
So with respect to TED Talks and podcast, there was a recent podcast that I was listening to. It was given by Dominique Price and it was a TED podcast. So in that podcast, he discussed about the science of motivation. So we generally associate motivation in terms of, for example, if you want to improve the productivity of a person in a corporate setup, we would try to give him financial incentives to increase that motivation. But he argues otherwise. He says that when a job is mechanical, that financial motivation will help increase in the productivity of the individual. But whenever there is a cognitive aspect which are involved in the working, that financial motivation will not help. He also goes on to say this example of the encyclopedia which we all use, and he argues that Australia was the first to design that encyclopedia, but it could not succeed despite giving the best of the financial aids to the system and to the setup. But then came the idea of encyclopedia where people could actually write it for free. They said that you want to do encyclopedia, go and write the information because you want to do it, because you have the motivation to do it. So that is one lesson that I've learned, that when we want to improve the productivity of people around us, of ourselves and our associates, we need to find the right motivations to improve those productivities.
What motivates you?
There's a lot of factors that motivate me. One of them being that being the idea of satisfaction. Being the idea of satisfaction means that whenever I do something, it's not just the financial incentive that is there, but I should be able to derive some value out of it. I should be able
so
to
is
derive.
Is it fair to say that you're not satisfied with Indian Railway personnel service?
I would beg to differ with you, sir, here.
You are aspiring for more, so you're not satisfied.
Sir, I'm very much happy being in the Indian Railways as of now. It's an excellent organization to work for, and it is helping me grow as an individual. But at the same time, sir, I believe that being IAS was one of the dreams that I had for a very long time. And for that reason, sir, I had my attempts, so I thought of trying one more time. And I also believe that this will help me capitalize better on my capabilities and help me give a wider encompass.
Good.